guys, how are you? So in this video today, I'm gonna be doing something a little bit different. I'm going to be talking to you about the products and the things that I use to keep my voice in tip-top shape. So I'm gonna be talking a little bit about vocal health today, some tips that I have, and if that interests you, keep on watching. Now today I'm in my dressing room, so the setup is a little bit different, but I'm in between the shows today. And I thought, what better time than to show you in kind of my habitat here and show you the products that I use. They're my go-to products to keep me in the best shape possible. At this point in my career, I know what products work for me and which ones don't, and it is very, very personal. Something that I love and can't live without may be something that you detest. It's very, very personal. Your health is very personal, obviously. But these are some of the products that I personally will not sign a contract without. They are always at my station, and I would love to show you what I use today, and hopefully this video will be helpful to you. Some of the things that I'm about to mention to you may seem very common knowledge, but to other people, maybe not so much. So let's get into them. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna start with is very obvious, but it's a toughie for me. It's just water. I am the worst when it comes to drinking water. When I'm not working on a contract, I hardly drink it. I know that's awful, but if you're using your voice every day in a strenuous manner, the best thing you could do is drink as much water as possible. Now, the thing you have to keep in mind too is, say you have a show or a presentation that you need to use your voice for, and you think an hour before the performance, I'm gonna chug this whole thing of water and then I'll be set. But you can't think of it that way, only because nothing ever really touches your vocal cords. The water, when you drink it, isn't going to be, you know, touching your vocal cords. So you can't just, you know, gulp a gallon of water before a performance and be like, I'm hydrated, my vocal cords will work perfectly, they're gonna be lubricated, it'll be great. That's not really how it works. You almost need to hydrate your body from the inside out first. So, you know, you have to take in preparation days before a big performance to make sure that you get adequate water so that your vocal cords are moist, so that you can lubricate the tissue from the inside. I usually like to think, like, as much water I drink today is gonna affect me tomorrow. So just drink a lot of water. And more than you think, just do it. Nike, not sponsored. You definitely need to invest in a personal steamer. I use this one every single day when I'm on contract. If I have a two-show day, I use it in between shows. This will get to your vocal cords and moisturize them faster than it would if you were just to drink water. This is the quickest way to get moisture right to your cords. It's fantastic. If you're serious about your career as a singer or actor, just buy it. It's like, I think it's like $40. It's not the cheapest thing. I mean, you can do the whole like pot, you know, on the stove with a tap. No one's doing that. Take this with you. You can get it at CVS. You can get them online. Even if you just have a regular cold, this will help. If you are feeling a little bit strained, too much singing, too much talking, this will help. You know, people say like, take a long shower. Not everybody has time to do that. If you have 10 minutes, even 10 minutes with the personal steamer, you will see an extreme, extreme difference in a good way for your speaking voice, your singing voice. There's no way your vocal cords will be able to vibrate properly if they are not hydrated, and this is a very quick, fast, and easy way to get them there. Now, another something is like a cult classic here. It's not for everybody, but it is apple cider vinegar. This one specifically, it's the Bragg Organic Raw Unfiltered Apple Cider Vinegar with the mother. Benefits of the apple cider vinegar is that it contains a lot of vitamin C, it cuts through phlegm. There's no scientific evidence that it, say, correct an infection or reduce inflammation in your vocal cords, but it's very personal. Person to person finds, you know, either you love it or you don't. I do love it. As you can see, I'm almost done with this bottle. Sometimes I just sprinkle it in with my tea in the morning, or you can put it, you know, you can cut it with water too if it's a little too much for you. I just find it really helps with my digestion, my overall wellness. It's great. So it definitely works for me in helping break up some of that mucus that I can have, especially during this season. On the same lines for antibacterial purposes, I have been really getting into oregano oil. Now, not just every oregano oil. You need a specifically, they say, the P73. It's like organic wild oregano oil. So I did a lot of research before I really started ingesting any sort of oils, because I do know my ear, nose, and throat doctor was telling me a lot of oils can give you acid reflux, and that is a problem that I used to suffer from, so I was a little bit uneasy about starting, you know, a health routine involving essential oils, but I'm finding that this one is great. I only use it if I feel like something is coming on. I don't use this every single day. I just feel like, you know, if I'm feeling a little extra phlegmy, you know, that feeling right before you get a cold, any sort of, you know, throat tickling, I just either drop a couple of these drops on my tongue or put it in a little bit of water and then drink that in the morning and in the nighttime. And I find either the next day or the day after that, I feel exponentially better. And I'd rather, you know, use something organic than, you know, go for Mucinex again. And I found that it really helped too with vocal fatigue. So I keep this on my station as well. Oreganol is the brand. It's from North American Urban Spice. But yeah, this is amazing. I got this on Amazon. Okay, now we're getting to the good stuff. On contracts, especially for musicals, for me, the number one key is to keep my vocal cords hydrated. And on these long contracts, you can have 8 show weeks, 9 show weeks, I'm sure you can have even more than that. Keeping your vocal cords hydrated was not only with the water, but I had to supplement as well. And it was during the spring to summer and then summer to fall changing of the seasons. So I got, you know, every cold in the book, every flu, and calling out is really just not an option. So I, you know, went on the computer, I did my research, and I came up with a couple throat drops that are my holy grail throat drops. I will not do a contract without them. I've actually gotten a little bit obsessed with them, which I'm sure isn't the best thing, but I love them anyway, so I can't wait to discuss them with you now. So the first throat drops I want to talk about are these. They're from Pine Brothers, and they are holy grail at this point. There's so many good things to say about them. One, there isn't any sort of medicine, like true medicine in them. So you can feel free to use them as frequently as you want to, which is something that I tend to do. The number one thing for singers that you're not supposed to do is have anything with menthol in it. The reason being is because it kind of numbs your throat, and that's good if you're having a lot of pain while swallowing or singing or speaking. But what it does is it gives you the false effect that you're better, let's say. And so if you're numb in your throat from the menthol, you go to sing, you know, more than you should if you're ill, or speak more, and then once the menthol wears off, you know, you're kind of left now with a sorer throat because you had this effect that you were better and you really weren't when you should be taking care of yourself. So the great thing about these Pine Brothers ones is that there is no menthol in it. The two flavors that I love are the vitamin C orange flavor and the sugar-free wild cherry flavor. Both equally amazing. They boast, it says on the package, number one throat coating action. And that kind of spoke to me because I was like, oh, I want my vocal cords to be super lubricated. I want them to be very moisturized. And when you hear like throat coating action and it says like number one, and I know that like that may sound like a gimmick, but it is really, really true. And what's also great about them is when I use like a regular, like say a Ricola or something, I tend to just crunch it and it's gone. With these, they say softish throat relief, which is hysterical to me because that's exactly how I would describe them. They're almost like a gummy, it's like a hard gummy throat drop. So I'm able to chew it almost, have it keep its shape for a little bit at least. They get like a little bit sticky, but in a to me, a delightful way. It's not like a crunch and then swallow. It's, they keep their shape, they're chewy. I don't know, I just love them. I think they are incredible. And they are very, very easy to find. You can find them at grocery stores, you can find them at, you know, places like Target, which is not always the case for some of the other things that I've been talking about today. Sometimes you have to go through websites or Amazon, you have to wait a couple days. These are like, I'm out, I have to go get them, and the fact that I can get them at the drugstore, the grocery store is a definite perk for me. They've been around for like 145 years, so they know what they're doing. I just think it's incredible. These are really, really effective, and they're always in my station. I won't do a show without them. So another throat drop that I want to talk about is amazing, and this came at a time in my life that I would have spent any money, I would have taken any medicine to feel better. It was one of those situations where it was like the perfect storm. I had gotten an infection in my throat, I had the flu, I completely lost my voice. It was during a show. It was awful, awful. And so what do you do when you're feeling this way is you definitely go online like and find anything. You know, other people's opinions, other professionals that have gone through this, what they recommend. And finally, I came across these throat drops, and they're called Vocal Zone. Now, I don't even know where these came from, God. And it's just incredible. So what I said before about no menthol, I still stand by that, because you don't want something that's going to numb you, or like I said, you could actually do more damage to yourself than you think that you're doing, more, you know, bad than good. These guys, the thing is, they have peppermint oil in it, they have myrrh, so that kind of goes against me saying like no menthol, because there is actually peppermint oil and myrrh in here that's going to give that effect. But the thing that's so special about them is it does give you a soothing quality, but it doesn't numb you. I can still feel everything I'm singing, you know, what I'm using, if I'm pushing, I can still feel everything. But the special thing about these is the texture, number one. Again, they have kind of, like the Pine Brothers, only a little bit harder. They're very malleable in your mouth. I know that's a weird thing to say, but you're able to chew them. They're very, very long lasting. What's great is they get a little bit tacky, and there have been times in my performances where I've actually like shoved one like up by my gum line and sang an entire like 11 o'clock number with one of the Vocal Zones in my mouth to keep my throat nice and hydrated. And they give that kind of, you know, what a peppermint oil would do, is it like refreshes your mouth and your throat. Its whole claim to fame is to keep a clear sound. You're not healing anything. It's not like a cough drop. This is for, it says it's helped to relieve throat irritation or dryness, which may occur if you've been talking, singing, smoking excessively, or if you have a cold. Like I said, a contract that I was just in for 4 months, these I got on Amazon, and I almost had them like automatically shipped to me every few weeks because I went through them. I had one each show. It really helped me keep my vocal cords in tip-top shape when I was doing 8-9 show weeks where I'm belting and skrelting and really yelling loudly. You can really do damage that way, and to have these throat drops in my life, I will not do a show without them. I love Amazon. These you definitely have to order online. You're not gonna find these, you know, at Superfresh. So they come in like a, you know, this little packet here, set of 24. And when you pop them out of the package, they definitely smell like weed. I don't know, maybe it's the myrrh, but they have like a weed smell, which definitely goes right away when you pop it in your mouth, but I think that's kind of funny. But I would definitely give them a try. If anything, go on Amazon and read the reviews. They are crazy, crazy awesome. Best, I love you. Ugh, I'm feeling a little tired because it's a two-show day. I'm gonna Pine Brother it up. Oh, so good. Another product that is always at my station, always in my cabinet at home, is Throat Coat. This tea is out of control amazing. I usually have the lemon echinacea flavor, but right now I just have the regular Throat Coat. It's organic, if that's, you know, something you're into. It has that slippery elm in it, it has licorice, it has marshmallow root in it. It's just absolutely fantastic. It's caffeine free, so you can like sip it all day. You just gotta make sure you steep it for a little bit of time so that it really comes out of the tea bag. The flavor isn't for everybody. I personally don't mind it at all. I kind of like licorice anyway, but it's something you will definitely get used to, and you will be happily getting used to, because you'll see how much of a brilliant difference it makes if you're feeling a little fatigued in your throat, if you have a cold. This is the tea to get. They sell them at most specialty grocery stores. Just pick this up, Throat Coat. Do it. these products are what I use to really make sure that I'm able to do my job and do it well and continue to love it. These are the products that help me. I hope that this video has helped you. Please look at the description below. I have links to all the products. I fully back all of them. If you have any tips that you use, I would love to see them in the comments below. I'm sure the viewers would appreciate it too. Click the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you haven't already. And that's it. I will see you in the next one. Bye.
I like hardly touched the front of my brow. I just spoolied and used the spoolie to kind of shimmy it towards me.